Hello.
Welcome.
Got a very special beer now.
There we go.
This is for Andrew. This was a beer given to us in a beer mail via Amanda Hunt. She's a fan of Fuller's and used to work. This is the Old Burton Extra. They're past masters. We are a fan of the other ones. I think there's double stout.
The Hook Norton.
No, Fuller's double stout.
Oh, right.
I think there's another one. There's a strong bitter.
Right.
You had this.
Past master versions.
Yeah, I wonder where we're going with this.
A bit clueless then. Yeah.
I'll just rip it off.
You sure?
Yeah. Okay. That's fine. That's probably using the same glasses. Normally we use alternate, but to be fair, we've drank enough and basically they're using fancy glasses now. Not three glasses.
It's lovely, nutty brown colour.
Very caramelly, it's like strong, dark, reddish brown.
Yes.
7.3%.
Like a nutty caramel, yeah.
It's very caramelly on the smell. Let's have a look. An authentic recipe from 1931. Since 1845, every Fuller's Ed brewer has kept a handwritten book or brews. The Past Master series uses the precise archive of brewing knowledge to revive selected long-lost beers for today's connoisseurs. It's a glimpse into our unique brewing history. Old Burton Extra is the third in a series brewed to the Old Burton Extra recipe from 1931. This ale is wonderfully strong and fruity, balanced with a pronounced old flavour. Bloody
hell. On the taste though, it's like, you get that slight intense flavour, but it's smoothed off, like caramelised, like you're saying, you know what I mean? But it leaves your mouth quite, quite sticky.
Yeah.
So.
It leaves a weird aftertaste.
It's like a chalky bitterness, you know what I mean?
It tastes like Marston's Pedigree, which has been left for 50 years. I'm getting like caramelly, apple-y smell. To be fair, the bitter was solid. The stout was awesome.
Yeah, for that one, you have to rate it, don't you? So it was so intense, the flavour. It was actually better than the vintage.
Yeah, true. The vintage was blah. We have got the 2012 vintage in the cellar, courtesy of Amanda, because I was in America and Andrew was working like a crazy man. But of the three so far we've tried from the Past Masters, I think this is the worst.
Yeah, I think the extra strong one, what is it?
Yeah.
I liked the extra strong one. I could easily drink a couple of them, but obviously it's knocked me off. Double stout, you have a bottle of that, you'll be fine. I mean, it's really, really intense flavour. And this one, it's argumentatively, you know what I mean? It's got a different flavour. It's maybe that Burton taste. I don't know. Does it have that Burton taste?
Well, back then, I think.
I should have said it on trend taste.
We've been there. We've been on there a few ale trails and road trips. It's a beautiful place, very scenic. Granted, some of the pubs got spiders all over them. Andrew will tell you that.
I'm covered in them, you know what I mean? It's like, I just ended up walking into them and I was like,
spider dance.
I didn't even notice.
But it just tastes like Marston's Pedigree, to be fair.
Yeah, I mean,
it's got a lot of all the hype, but it just tastes like Marston's Pedigree. For the price, I think probably if it was in the shops, it'd probably like £3 to £4, whereas Master Pedigree is like £2. Get Master Pedigree.
But on a note though, as the more you drink it, the more you get that distinctive taste.
It's true, because it's 7.3%, whereas the Master Pedigree, I think, is 4.3%. So it's like all different volume. But out of the three past Masters we've had, I'd have to say the Double Stout's the best. This is the worst. Would I recommend people to buy it? No.
I'd say try it, but other than that, I wouldn't turn them on that.
Try it, but...
It's a peculiar taste.
Share it, to be fair.
Yeah.
You take care. Goodbye.